lights a little bit, because we don't want to die in an emergency room. We want to die with nice, soft light, very calm, very quiet. Yeah, it's okay. It's fine. It's okay. So if you have space to lie down, you can lie down. If the person, if the people are lying down, they start snoring, which they do usually, don't kind of burst out laughing. Touch them gently and wake them up. Because that's the danger. If you do lie down, the danger is that you fall asleep. Okay? Take your time to get installed. Because the more you're comfortable, the more you can concentrate on these, just on these visit, on these visions. So all you do, actually, I will tell you what to visualize, and then you'll just visualize it. There's more mattresses coming if you need. Okay. So while people are preparing over there, if you are already settled, you can start thinking, you know, what we discussed today, with what kind of mind state would I like to die? So you need to look back at your life. Am I happy with the life I led? Are there still things that I need to settle? So it's good to think about these things now, so at the time of death might be too late. So maybe, you see, at the time of death it could still be that we are still have an illusion that we're not dying. Maybe we see how the doctors shake their heads, how finally your friends become very quiet, don't know where to look, don't know what to say. So we might get a feeling, oh, this is probably it. So for the moment, we could imagine or we could think everything has been said. Everything has been done. I can go peacefully and concentrate on these death absorptions or the dissolutions. So the first element that loses its power is the earth element. The aggregate of form, our body. You lose power over the body, you cannot move your limbs anymore. You might have a feeling as if the limbs are not stuck to the body anymore. And you might have a feeling as if you're either pushed underneath the earth, or that the earth is not supporting you, and just you have a feeling of falling into a bottomless pit. Your eye consciousness absorbs, so even if your eyes are open, the sight becomes unclear. And your inner vision is filled like a mirage, like hot, flimmering air on a hot summer day when you drive on the road, like a Fata Morgana. second element it absorbs is the water element. All the body liquids will dry up, like the saliva, the sweat, the blood. At that moment, the sensations that come from the body are of either pleasant, unpleasant, or neutral. You're not perceiving them anymore as pleasant, unpleasant, or neutral. Outside sounds become very distant. And your inner vision is filled with smoke. Next element that absorbs is the fire element. So the body heat retracts towards the heart, your limbs become cold. You cannot digest food or drink anymore. Also, you're no longer really mindful of who these people are who are standing around your bed, even though they might be closed ones, because the mind starts to disconnect. You lose the ability to smell, and your inhalation is labored and weak. And your exhalation strong and lengthy. And your inner vision is filled with sparks within that smoke. And the wind or the air element absorbs. You stop breathing. You cannot perform physical actions anymore and are no longer mindful of external activities, of their purpose, and so on. You lose the ability to taste and to experience smoothness or roughness. You would be declared clinically dead. And you have an inner vision of a very big dark room that is filled with a very dim, unstable light, like a candle or a burning butter lamp that is just about to go out. Okay, so then now the more subtle energy body kind of loses to be a support for the mind. So the energy winds or the prana or the chi that are in these channels in the upper part of your body, they all gather at the crown of your head, the top of your head, and enter the central channel. And push that white drop downwards, and your inner vision is filled with a very clear vacuity filled with white light, like the light reflecting on snow on a clear full moon night. So it's not a direct white light, it's more just a reflection. And the energy winds of the lower part of the body enter the central channel at the base of the spine. Push the red drop that we have from the mother, who is at the navel, push it upwards. And your inner vision is filled with copper red light, like the very clear sky at sunset sometimes. There's no horizon, there's only space. A space, a limited space, filled with copper red light. And these two drops meet at the heart chakra, they get locked into each other. And then you would have a vision of outer darkness without any light source from wherever. And then when all these winds dissolve, then that's the moment where the mind is at its most subtle level, it's called the clear light. And there's no more, you know, the I that is experiencing that has disappeared long ago, you become the experience. So at that moment, what appears is like the very clear sky on a fresh autumn morning, just before the sun comes up. If you look at it, there's no beginning, there's no obstruction, there's no end, there's no border. It's just luminous space, which is the nature of our mind, without any elaboration, with nobody separate experiencing it. And then when the clear light is finished, it is only then that this very subtle mind of clear light, together with the very subtle wind and together with the karmic imprints, our karmic potentials, leaves this body. The body would start to decay. The mind, with a kind of what is called dream body, would go into an intermediate state and stay there looking for the next rebirth, but we're not going that far. Because we're just training how to die. So when you are reborn, the whole thing goes in the reverse order, so you can visualize from the clear light, you have the black of the darkness appearance. From there, the copper red light. From there, the white light. from there, the flickering candle. From there, the sparks within the smoke. From there, the smoke. And from there, the mirage. So now, very gently, very slowly, you become aware of your body again. You feel where it makes contact with the ground, either just your feet or your whole body, the back of your body or your bum, sitting on a cushion. Take a few deep breaths, knowing that you're breathing in when you're breathing in, knowing that you're breathing out when you're breathing out, moving your fingers and toes, really bringing the mind back to the body, being aware of the body, and know who you are and where you are. And then you can slowly start moving again or sit up. And if you feel a bit spacious or spaced out, that's quite okay because it's normal. Because all of a sudden we feel that the mind is much more spacious than we thought. And so we can dedicate all the positive energy that we have created today by thinking about the meaning of our life. Finding a meaning, finding a way how to live that meaningful life, knowing that the situation is not going to last. And we dedicate all this positive energy, especially to those beings who are going through this process right now, not just training, but who are dying. May they will be able to die peacefully, composed, as we did just now. And when our time for dying has come, also may we remember these stages, may we be concentrated, aware, awake, clear, no panicking. And then when we are in the natural clear light, to experience it as the nature of our mind. Well, beings have happiness and the causes of happiness. Well, beings be free from suffering and the causes of suffering. May we all learn ways and means not to hurt each other. May everybody have access and interest in spiritual teachings. How to develop a peaceful mind, an open heart. And may all the teachers, no matter from what tradition, who teach these methods to develop a good heart, to decrease the negative emotions, may they all have long, stable, and healthy lives. And whenever it's our time to die, also in our next rebirth, may we always be in contact with these wonderful methods, with trustworthy teachers, so we can realize these stages of the path, quickly attain enlightenment, and lead all sentient beings to that state as well. if you have problems going to sleep, this is also helpful when you visualize these visions, if you know them. You usually don't get very far and then you're sleeping, because the mind is doing it naturally. As you go to sleep, we're just not aware of it. So have a very good night. May you recognize your dreams as dreams. And in the morning, when you wake up, may we also be aware how wonderful it is to be alive and to be able to do these things together.